Yo guys, what's good? Welcome back to a new video. In today's video, we're going to make a custom AF1's one, so it will have a 6ix 9ine design on it. And basically, in today's video, we're going to recreate a custom somebody has actually already made, so this artist right here. And well, we'll figure out how we can recreate this design, and I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. And with that being said, let's get straight into today's video. Alright, for today's custom we need several colors, so we need some red, yellow, orange, green, some blue, and some white and some black. And of course we'll start our custom as always with preparing and glazing the So basically we use some acetone and some cotton swabs, and we put the acetone on our cotton swabs and drop over the shoe panels where we want to paint on. Next step is taping up today's custom. Now I'm also getting ready the stencils which we need for the 6ix 9ine design. Make sure to place your stencil symmetrically to the surrounding leather panels. You can also use a heat brush in order to adhere your stencils even closer onto your shoe. Now just take light airbrush coats and fill in your stencils. This will give you super crispy lines when you peel off the stencils in the end. So now that that looks really crispy, we can go ahead with our next step. And that's essentially cutting our tape to size, because as you can see in this picture right here, we have different colored lines and they are each 2 centimeters wide, though my tape was 2.5 centimeters wide, so I had to cut it down to 2 centimeters. Now I'm basically putting the tape onto our shoes, so I would know where I have to put the red stripe later on and also the other colored stripes. And I'm laying it symmetrically to the panels that you can see on the left and the right hand side. So after laying down all the tape stripes, I'm now going ahead and I'm basically writing the names onto the tape stripes, so later on while painting I wouldn't put any colors on the wrong spots where they shouldn't be. So once we have taped up the whole shoe and know where we have to put our colors, now we can go ahead and start from the back. So I like starting from the outside to the inside part, and that's basically by painting with blue first. For the green, as you can see, we have some lighter green. I don't have that on stock, so I just mixed some dark green and some white to achieve this green color which we need for the specific area right here. Also be careful to not color the sock liner, since you can't really remove the paint in the end, so really take your time here and then you should be really fine. So that's how the shoe looks like after putting down several colors, and now I can peel off the last tape stripe and basically then just fill in those white stripes with some fire red. Now to finish up today's custom, I'm also still putting some black color on the edges as we have seen it from the original custom. And of course I'm also still now adding the drip onto the shoes. Now of course also what I didn't show in this specific part of today's video is that I still applied the finisher in the end onto the shoe that the color would really last. Alright you guys, so that's finally gonna wrap up today's video, and what I've just recognized while editing is that we have hit the 1k, and that's like super crazy to me, and I'll still do the video that I've told you guys about in the beginning of this or the last video. So anyways, that will still come in like 2 weeks, I guess, because I really want to create a special shoe. And well, with that being said, video for next week is already planned, and I'm really happy with how today's shoe came out, and here are the final shots.